There are two police officers here. One is controlling the vehicles on a complicated road. The other is boarding a helicopter and patrolling a highway. Both are traffic police officers with the same purpose, but one is called the road traffic police and the other is called the aerial police. So, what about the air traffic controller, the traffic police officer of the sky? What is the first impression that comes into your mind? Looking down to the aircrafts from the control tower? Sitting in a dark room and staring at the radar screen? Yes, both are air traffic controllers. One is called the tower controller and the other is called the radar controller. Tower controllers work at a control tower and land control of the airport. Radar controllers work at radar approach facility or area control center. So, what is the difference? Probably, most people who doesn't work in the aviation field don't know much about these. Then, from now on, let's take a step closer to tell the difference between the tower controller and the radar controller.
Naked eyes versus radar scope. The tower controller works at the control tower. The control tower is located at the highest place of the airport, and all sides are made of glass windows, so controllers can see everywhere. Many people may wonder whether it is possible to monitor aircrafts using equipment such as CCTV, but that is a very dangerous idea. The control tower is responsible for the aircraft's taking off and landing moments. However, the pace in which the aircraft departing and landing is the most dangerous section during flight. The aircraft may suddenly encounter a flock of birds, or there may be vehicles entering the runway without permission. The pilot accidentally lands without downing the landing gear. In addition, all aircraft's movement areas of the airport must be monitored, including ramps, taxiways, and runways. Can all of these situations be controlled by a surveillance device like a CCTV? Impossible. This role should only be played in real time through the eyes of the controller. In other words, the tower controller must see aircraft directly with naked eyes. On the other hand, radar controllers control aircraft at high altitudes, so they rely on the aircraft's information received from radar equipment. They must monitor the aircraft's position, speed, and altitude through a radar scope. There is no window in the control room, the lighting is dark, and there is no need to be in a high place. The radar controller sees aircrafts through the air traffic control radar. Large area through one screen versus small but the entire area. Although there are differences among countries, the tower controller usually controls the airport radius of 5 miles. The radar approach controller controls the airport radius up to 60 miles, and the ACC controller controls more. But there is something interesting here. In fact, radar controllers that control a large area ironically focus on just one radar scope. Within that one radar scope, there are numerous aircrafts to be controlled and signs indicating nearby airports, mountains, and obstacles. The radar scope displays the aircraft's heading, altitude, speed, and call sign information. On the other hand, the tower controller, which controls a much smaller area, must turn its head from side to side and keep the field of view wide. For example, suppose a controller issues a taking off clearance to an aircraft. At this time, the controller should comprehensively check not only the taking off aircraft, but also the entire runway and other landing aircraft. In other words, the actual control radius is much wider for radar controllers, and the radius of the field of view seen by the controller is wider for tower controllers. Ground personnel versus radar controller in adjacent area. All aircraft moving areas, permission of the control tower is required for the movement of vehicles and people as well as aircraft. Ground personnel, such as bird alert teams, runway inspection vehicles, aircraft guided vehicles, sweeping vehicles, and emergency rescue vehicles, and tower controllers communicate more than a dozen times a day. There are also several walkie-talkies for contacting all of them. In other words, the tower controller communicates frequently with many ground vehicles and personnel. On the other hand, radar controllers must communicate with radar approach facilities or area control center and adjacent areas frequently. When the aircrafts are transferred or handed off to each other's traffic control area, the controllers exchange and coordinate information such as the aircraft's altitude, destination, and location.
Not only that, there are many differences between the tower controller and the radar controller. The phraseologies used by radar controllers is longer than the phraseologies used by tower controllers. Radar controllers mainly control IFR aircraft, and tower controllers mainly control VFR aircraft. Sunglasses are necessary for tower controllers who are always exposed to sunlight through glass windows. The radar controllers, of course, don't need sunglasses. However, even if it is decided as a tower or radar controller at first, it may change later. Although the detailed standards set by country are different, most controllers rotate the tower control and the radar control at regular intervals. The radar controller's control will be easier if the tower controller's provides good separation and landing order. If the radar controller provides good separation between landing aircrafts, the tower controller becomes easier to control their traffics. In other words, the tower controller and the radar controller are not only doing their own work, but also understanding and working closely as a team is crucial and essential. Both tower controllers and radar controllers exist to prevent collisions and maintain order of air traffic and pursue common goals. That is, flight safety. Under this common goal, the tower controller and radar controller are just a team. There are many differences, but flight safety is secured solid when they interact closely. How can the sky road be safe today? This is because there is two controllers in one team. ATC for you.